All right, so we're gonna be doing another Kraken franchise game. So the team is currently third in the Pacific, but in the entire league, we are ranked ninth. So. That's alright. And then player stats. Keller has 35. And then Kilhoma with 32. And then Krebs has 31. Quinn with 30. But keep in mind, Quinn's only played 42 games, where these two played 47. So I think they've played all the games. They haven't been out yet. And then Krebs has played all but one game. And so he is in the other five games if he got like a point per game. But is there an average? Who's the best shooting percentage? Oh, Gurdjieff has like the highest percent, I guess. Yoki Haru has one goal on 43 shots for 2.3% shot chance for going in. With him, he has 118 shots with three goals, 106 shots with three goals for 2.8. So yeah, who has the highest percentage in at least 10 games? Nobody's played 50 games yet, so Krebs probably, I'd say. Yeah. I don't even think we ever looked at the awards. Okay, of course the Lightning won. Presence Trophy, Leeds, the Clarence went to the Blackhawks, Tampa Bay won the Prince of Wales Trophy. No, not the HL. The individual awards. Oh, this went to Matthews. Matthews went to Har. The Norris. And the sportsmanship. Tomasino. Jones. Then go Vesna. So Hall's been dedicated, I guess. Oh nice, I got had to contribute. Oh nice, so our coach must have contributed the most, arguably. Well, Barkov, Lindsay, Selkie, Ted Lindsay. Goes to Matthews. Maurice Richard goes to Matthews because Matthews definitely wins like four or five trophies. On top of his team like finishing the best in the league, probably due to him. But there's we lost in the shootout on the both teams got a shutout though. I think. I think they tallied up both in shutouts. Let's see if we can beat. Is this like his brother, Caden Louie or whatever? I'm not sure if this is his brother, maybe. You know what, let's beat his brother. Bailey, I know he's gonna be old, but yeah, we're definitely not getting him in. Hello. So, centers, we got 1, 2. Oh, it's... Nope. We take that loss. We're still third in our division. We're behind by 5 points. And we played 2 less games. Canucks are better than the Knights because Canucks played 3 less games, you know? Ooh! Matthews is a 96 overall. Taylor Hall, Matthews, and Marner. Mitch Marner. Ooh, they almost got perfect shooting. So basically, I have 5-star everything. Oh yeah, I wonder why this team won, because I have all over 80s. 90 and 82, 85, 82, 83, 81, cheese. Oh, and of course they took Saros from us. Because they definitely needed him. Definitely weren't like good enough anyway. McCabe, Sherrod, and Dermot on the back. Oh, of course I took Dermot back. Does Kill Holmes got a perfect shooter? No, his accuracy went down to 96. Come on, I challenge Cajon to at least a point this game. Doesn't have to be a goal, could be an assist. But get a point this game, buddy. It's been a while since he got the point on us. Oh, when we were playing. Just moments away from puck drop, both teams. Oh gosh. You know what? Let's roll up these lines. See if maybe they have a good idea. I might not like these lines, but maybe these are good lines according to them anyway. Like if the game literally thinks these are like such good lines, maybe they are. They feel retarded, but whatever, we'll try them out.
Broken up with the stick in the defensive zone. Here's a short pass to Marner. Can't get it to go. The Leafs will play the puck from behind. And he connects with the long ball. Taken by Matthews. With possession along the wall. And that one's broken up.
It's too far in front of him.
Sharp reaction save. Sends the pass over. Here's a rock into a shot. Stop that one. Takes the pass. Okay. And it's a quick pass to Riley.
I just don't like when they put these random guys in here that I don't like. Not as much like when they put other guys, but then they put a center out as my first line right wing, so then you gotta sacrifice like a winger at center for another one, or like Fitzwook. We got a winger, center, center, winger, center, right wing, and then winger, center, center. And then a right, a left wing, center, right wing. Oh, I guess then, but. And then they just got Yoki Haru here instead I would bring these guys down, bring this guy down here and this guy here. But it doesn't matter. I mean, ultimately, these ones are awful. I just don't love them. They seemed worse. They seemed awful because I think we had like a winger there before, but now we have Ryan Suzuki, so he can be our fourth line center. I mean, the thing is, we have a bunch of centers. excuse me, jeez. But it seems like every franchise I've ever done, I always have way too many centers and way too many left D, but not enough right D. I don't know, the lefty are just way better in this game. Any right defensemen are not very good in this game, really.
Smartphone cases. They got you covered at the team store. Check them out online or you can
visit just outside
the arena. Open 7 days a week. Picked up along the wall by Lindgren. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Kraus. Off target. Chase from along the wall. Reason with a save. More than half the frame has been played here. Still looking for our first goal. Seattle's won the faceoff.
Mm-hmm.
Toronto's got control of it now from their own end. Sends it out right in front. And they can convert on the play. Slides the puck over. Play is whistled dead as the puck goes up and over.
And both
centers glide into the dot as a face-off set to resume. Puck is dropped and play resumes. That's set in deep. The Leafs gain control of the puck against the wall. Mikheyev's moving it ahead. Puck dumped in. The Kraken have taken possession in their own end. Here they come up along the wing.
Players tell us all the time that they don't know where the next milestone is. That's garbage. They know when they're one goal away from a plateau. I think he's looking for it here.
His reflexes on display tonight.
Change lines, come on!
Seattle's got the puck in their own end. Along the side, here they come through the neutral zone. That's blocked by Saros. And they'll get a breather as the goaltender covers it up.
We could kill homos in the top. That's good, we have a stat leader, although the stat leader isn't hit, but that's a good stat to be leading in. Only bad stat to be leading in is like penalty wins. Let's go! And Gooley gets a goal for that! Let's go! I knew if he like tried to grab him, I knew if he like fully get possession, because he's only getting fully...
Nice job tying up his opponent. Takes the feed. And now it's over to Tavares. Moves it up through the middle from the right.
Ooh, it's just a good buddy. Ooh. Tell me why that actually works. She's close to the goalie. Sandy gets it.
He's struggling. Toronto's looking to break out of their own end.
John Tavares.
Along the boards, they battle for the puck back and forth. Great use of the stick here at center ice. He almost lost it for a second there, but regains control of the puck. Denies him in close.
Excellent chance. They work the puck into position, and it's a scoring chance. It's turned away.
Gobbles that puck up with his chest. Thank you.
with that, the first period is in the books. Both teams with a chance and a refresh. We'll get a
I was going to say, who's our goalie? But that's right, I forgot. We got Robin Lennon.
Along with the team,
he's debuting for us. Underway.
Moves it quickly over to Hall. Textbook stop by Leonard.
I'm going to say, who's his goalie?
We got to stop as the puck sails
over the line. We have to give up for him.
James Cebulski, Ray,
we had to give up for
the early going of this period.
One nothing
is where we sit at this point. Seattle's won the draw.
One like the center or left wing to play with him.
Gains the zone to the center.
Rips
it and rips it! And he comes up with the save!
Oh.
Play is called for offside.
That's not Vanish, is it? Because I knew it's not our... I was like, goalie. With an X factor, because I would have seen the X factor plus he's number one. But yeah, that's right. I completely forgot that I got the new guy.
He's working hard to find this puck. There's all kinds of traffic in front of him, and he gets to it before the puck gets to him. Seattle's won the draw. And they won't connect on that one. It's a fancy footwork to kick it over to his teammate. Takes a shot. Slick work with the glove by Saros. Slides it diagonally to Simmons. Tries to connect the pass, but it doesn't go. Grabs the puck in the defensive zone. And they cough it up in the neutral zone. Takes the feed at center from the right wing. Seattle's got possession of the puck. Floats the saucer pass. Quick pass to Anderson. Gets a little piece of it and keeps it out of the net.
Line change.
From one end of the blue line to the other. Toronto's regained possession of the puck. The Kraken have taken over in the neutral zone. And things start to ramp up a little bit now on the ice with that play. Drills them. Off a stick. And it's turned aside by Leonard. Takes the pass from his goaltender. From the right side, takes the pass. Tremendous stop by Saros. Toronto's got a hold of the puck now. Seattle's got it in the neutral zone. And he's going out on the air.
I got my shot off with Spider. I would have scored. Obviously, I wouldn't have fought. Because I got the fight.
Not gonna let him fight.
Clinton is not going to stand up for himself. No. That's why we got you, Joshy boy. Jeez, we can't reach him right now.
There we go. And sends him down to the ice. That's a clear decision there.
We lose some arm length or what? Because halfway through, we just couldn't hit anything. We're missing everything.
After they pick themselves up here, they'll head to the penalty box to serve their 5-minute penalty for fighting. Probably takes that long. They've got the debris all cleared up off the ice, and both teams step in for the face-off. Puck is dropped and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone. Quick feed to Barbashev. He stops him with a ball. Great reflexes there. Off a stick and they can't connect.
Turned across with L1 and then still come almost 10 feet offside.
Well past the midway mark of this period. Seattle's up 1-0. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. Seattle's playing it through center. Toronto's got a hold of it along the wall. Tried to get 2Q with it and loses possession. Funny, James, when you try something a little bit too much, you know halfway through it's not working anyway. I'm pretty sure that was the thought there. Both centers ready to take the draw here coming up. The Leafs get a hold of the puck in their own end.
Clear it!
along the boards. Slides it on over to Moore. And now he moves it to McKayev. Broken up with the stick in the defensive end.
Make a change.
Seattle's on the attack. Picked off by Moore. Through the middle of the ice, they enter the attacking zone. Slides the puck over to Keller. There's the whistle as the puck stopper wants to hang on. Getting into the later stages of this period, we got a 1-0 game to this point. The frozen biscuits dropped and we are back
on
the
line
here. Tripped up on the play and the referees caught that one. Time for the official to pass down his sentence. You can see the obvious frustration. He's just taken his second penalty of this period.
Yeah, guys, this power play is ranked top 10 in the league, and when they get that space and time, they can have some high danger chances, and let's see what happens here in the first one of the night.
Knocked in front. Pumps it away in his own end. Here's a short pass to Riley, and he comes up with it. Leonard's able to angle that save over to the corner so there's no rebound. Sends it across.
Cover it.
Saros makes another save, and James, they're not easy saves to make. He's had a great record tonight. We'll see if his team can get him another goal. Behind the net, looking for the transition game. Nice pass. Nowhere for that shot to go through. Moves it to Tavares.
Glennon's shot.
Tries to get it across to Marner. Couldn't complete the pass.
He's taken away from Matthews.
That's no surprise. I mean, after that hit that he took earlier in the shift, slowly working his way to the bench to get some help from the trainer.
Whistle blown, stopping the play.
A little bit of sorting out is going to have to happen here. Both officials are going to talk as there's more than one penalty on the play.
Toronto's power play unit puts their hard hats on as they go back to work.
The power play gets an unbelievable opportunity to tie this game up. Trailing by one, this is a big chance in this game.
Toronto's got the puck along the wall. Keeps possession on the play. Receives the pass. Toronto's across the blue line. Grabs the puck here in their own end. Can't connect on the pass. Saros carries the puck in his own zone. A little back and forth. The Kraken had the puck in the open ice. Misses.
Tough to generate a rebound even when the puck misses the net by that much.
Seattle's got it in the offensive zone.
10 seconds.
Oh, he gets a blocker on it. What a stop by Saros.
Anderson's ready to join the play.
Streaking through center, they go on the attack.
Lines,
Toronto's
on.
Man advantage, unable to execute properly. They still trail by a goal.
Get off real quick and change.
No, not much they're going to be able to do about that. The power play failed. Now they go back to full strength.
That's the work.
Kraken have the puck in their own end.
Anderson. He's laid out one more time.
And there's the save.
Looks like the part of his game is over, and it's now time to play hockey again.
There's the buzzer bringing the second period to an end. Been a great night of hockey here on EA Sports. We've got a third period just around the corner. Alongside Ray Ferraro between the benches, I'm James Cebulski, ready to bring you period number three. Moment of truth for one team. Here we go. Third period is underway. Well, we've got two periods under our belts to this point so far, Ray. How do you see things?
The Leafs are losing, and really the biggest indication is they haven't had the puck very much at all. A big discrepancy in puck possession time.
We've got a lot of questions. Like 3 and 2 offensive rules.
And he uses his reach to disrupt the play. And we'll get a face off.
And what? We never get. Seems like we never have someone there for the rebound. Oh my dude, it's pretty rare that we do.
Slides in off the wing after the centerman tied him up. Oh, and he just gets a piece of it. Great extension on the play.
No room for the shooter. The goaltender snuffed it out.
Here's a chance. Just off target.
So much work goes into creating a scoring chance these days. It's so hard to get good ones.
He's got a step. That's off a stick. The Leafs looking against the half wall. Takes the feed. Centering pass. Oh, that's a huge stop by Saros.
Their goals are equal to every shot.
Matthews can score several different ways. He's among the league leaders in goals because he's so hard to get a handle on.
Tavares has it in their own end. Takes the feed from the left side. Here he is in front. Spectacular stop by the goaltender. How did he hang on to that?
Sometimes you're in close, there's no room to put it anywhere. The goalie smothered it all.
Scooped up along the wall by Anderson. Errant pass and they can't connect. Moves across the point. Moves it quickly over to Pulsers. Picked up along the boards by Yukiharu. Pulsers picking up steam. Handles the puck. They gain the offensive zone for the middle. Seattle's got the puck. Moves it around along the half wall. And that's a great heads up in the defensive zone to force the turnover. And that pass can't connect. Barbashev's exploring his options behind the net. Makes it look easy with the
freeze
stop.
Freeze it.
Lindgren's got the puck in his own zone.
It hasn't been boring. I mean, it's low scoring, but man, there's been a lot of chances at both ends of the ice. We've seen missed chances combined with great goaltending, and that gives you a low scoring game.
What the flip?
Penalty coming up here.
Don't try to ask an interference. Oh! The puck was on his stick. You're not gonna call that interference. See, he made contact with it right there. Look at it, that's his stick. He has that surgeon stick. Watch this. Wait.
It's always a fine line penalty. You're allowed a little interference.
All right, fine. That didn't look like interference, but that is interference, I guess. It looked like he touched it, but never mind.
And maybe even help the team light the lamp.
Great read by the winger to take possession with the two centermen tied up. Taken along the wall by Marner. Puck picked up by Quinston. Toronto's got the puck. Can't carry it.
Freeze it.
Seattle's got it in their own zone. And they send it down the ice. Trying to get something going here with this man advantage as they start from their own end. Seattle's got the puck along the boards. Puts it in deep. Saros decides to cover it up for the whistle.
I don't mind this. The game's tight. You want to make sure that the decisions you make are the right ones. Too tough to make up a bad error now.
Barbashev's ready for the draw as we get set to resume this power play. Quick pass to Hall. The Kraken got the puck against the boards. Pokes it away to stay on the attack. Launches it from the point. The Kraken have gained control.
Put it around the other side.
They want to clear the zone here while they're trying to kill off this penalty. Oh, what a denial by Leonard.
I think through traffic like that, you're just hoping the thing hits you.
What a save! Let's go! I thought that was going in for sure.
Toronto's ready to go on the attack.
It was not attacking at all.
Penalty coming up. There's the whistle, and here's the call.
Even though he's not very happy here, James, I don't really know what his defense is. That's a penalty to me.
And it's four against four here with the puck set to drop.
Don't you come
once you get the puck on four, just don't give it up. You've got space. Use it.
And a good read to get possession there with the two centermen tangled up.
The puck.
Takes a shot. Gives them nothing in front. And puts the body into it, a little bumper car hockey. And that doesn't exactly go tape to tape. Cutting to the slot. Shots the puck away. And the goalie covers
the puck. Turn back here.
Past the midway mark of the frame. We are all tied up in this one. Krebs is quick on the draw. Oh, and a misfire as that goes right out of the zone. Gets it over to Pulsers. Their man's now out of the box, and they'll take advantage on the power play. And the puck clears the zone. Quick feed to Pulsers. Saros elects to hang on and get a whistle here, Ray.
Yeah, pretty soon, James, the players in front of them are running all over the place. They're trying to help, but they're not. That cover was important.
They'll get set to drop the puck as this power play continues. Well, that's one way to win the draw as he skates away with the puck after the two centers were tied up. Excellent stick work on the play. Slides the puck across to Riley. Sends the pass over. Quick stop by Leonard. Grabs the puck and moves on out here with this man advantage. Nice zone entry from the left. Anderson's got it along the wing. Turns it away on the slot shot. We'll get a face off after the puck stays covered up. Tavares slides into the face off dud, and they'll continue to try to kill off this penalty. Offensive zone face off, and he wins the draw. Denied by the goaltender.
The goalie gets himself out of any potential trouble by depositing that rebound into the corner.
Back at the point, they set it up. What a save! He'll probably feel that one tomorrow. And they get the puck out of the danger zone. And a tenacious effort face off as he comes up with it. Picked up along the wall by Tavares. Trying to clear from the defensive zone. Well, that went sideways, but they still maintain possession. Rinus plays it against the boards. Oh, we got a piece of it to keep it out. Toronto's got the puck in the defensive end. He clearly doesn't like that.
That's
no. Yeah, he's not going to have a choice here. He's been running around a little bit, been getting a little chippy, and now he's going to have to drop the mitts and answer for it.
And down he goes.
That's a clear winner right there.
Ray, it looks like they're not done with each other down there.
No, they're going to bark at each other on the way to the penalty box, but into the box they go. Time to sit down.
Face-off coming up here, and
but
this
the first
crowd
up
a little more ramped up after what we just witnessed moments
first
ago.
Defensive penalty.
Matthews wins the draw on their own end. Through center along the wing. Seattle moving it up the ice. The Leafs gain possession along the wall. Feeds the puck up to Matthews. Breakaway! And it kind of falls apart here at the end.
James, I'm going to assume he had a different idea about how that was going to finish up.
Grabbed along the boards by Myers. The Kraken have position along the boards. Just wide of the net. Slides it back to the blue line. And he stands tall in goal. Stuffs them again.
Yeah, pretty good positioning here, James. He makes the two stops back-to-back.
On the opposite point.
Score!
And score!
It's Ryan's ball. We'll take that. That has to be Ryan's ball, right? Because he tried to, he even tried to avoid it too. He didn't even have to try to avoid it. So, yeah, I suppose the Ryan's. I don't know if it was. Because didn't he try to like jump and hit him, I think? Right? I don't know why he's rushing at me like a defender. He jumped. And he tipped it down. Through the 5-pole. But Ryan's got injured. Wait, did it go off of him too? The way he reacted. Usually they only slam their stick as like if it went off of the defender will slam their stick like Dan and I hit it in. Ooh, 37 seconds left. That's clutch.
And that's not the side with the stick by Simmons. Toronto's trailing, that's why they've got the extra attacker out on the ice and Napoli on the bench. The Leafs have a hold on the defensive zone. Pulser setting up against the wall. And that's knocked away by Myers. From behind the net, looks to break out. The Leafs have it now. Along the wing, up the neutral zone. Seattle's got the puck in their own end.
Take the shot!
Fires it down the ice! And there's the insurance
mark.
For them on this night.
It's amazing how many times a guy misses an empty net, but this one he puts between the pipes.
Seattle's added to their lead with the empty netter, and Ray is pretty much all she wrote, I would say. Well, you grind away to get the
win. You know the win.
Much of the game, and they put the ball into the pressure.
I was going away, but then easy one into the decided to take it.
And there's the
because why not? As Dooley got one goal, and he had one hit on the
late, but really, they put themselves in this position to begin with here.
Well, you start chasing the game, James, and you get to the point where you got to take your goalie out, give it a last-ditch attempt. Just didn't work out for him.
Goal in the hit. There's 16 shots, so he hit pretty good. Didn't quite have a 900 save percentage. Oh wait, he did have a 900, did have a 950 though. Ooh, solid for Seros had a 933. Because we take a bunch of shots even though they're not good. He had a 938. We had a 938 versus their 933. See? What the flip? They give them a star, but we don't give. But I guess, I mean, they had that, they had, 29 saves, or no, no, 28 saves. He had a 933 on 31 shots, versus we did a little bit better, but on, like, basically half the shots. Yeah, that's gonna do it. Thank you guys so much for watching. As always, I hope you guys enjoyed and I hope to see you guys in the next one. Peace.